If you've been on the internet for a while, you most likely seen this little guy before. This guy takes on many different names, but I'll refer to it from its origin name, Emoticai. He's existed for way longer than what I think some would imagine, which I'll get to later. But the most interesting thing I found out about it is how it's used in a series of children's books. First of all, what is Emoticai? Originally, Emoticai is a 3D asset tool that's used to create emojis. And according to Know Your Meme, it began circulating on the Argentinian website, Taringa, in 2014, and was used to caption Spanish in-jokes. It then spread further in 2015, and is now used for various different purposes. That is basically how most people know it for, being a meme. But considering that the asset is free to use, it can be seen as a multi-purpose tool for other different projects. This is how the Emoticai can be seen in children's books. A while ago, my friend Korn found a kid's book called I Am Earth. The book is told from the point of view of the Earth itself, as it mentions all the basic information about the planet. The day and night cycle, seasonal changes, gravity, etc. It does have its own message at the end though, which is to take care of the Earth by recycling and other helpful means. It's a pretty standard children's book, all things considered. Looking at style, it's pretty obvious that it's Emoticai. Hell, it even turned into its own meme at one point. Curious to how similar this looks, I wanted to see the author's history. The book was created by James and Rebecca McDonald, a husband and wife who has a history of creating children's books about the planets of our solar system, as well as animals and other children's learning basics. Some of their works are written in different languages, and what I can assume is to reach a wider audience. There's not much info about them available, apart from the wife having her own YouTube channel, where she does read-alongs of their works.
I would like to say thank you very much to all of the people working so hard to take care of each other and our very precious planet.
And a husband being the illustrator for their books. For the sake of the video, I'd like to focus on their I Am Planet series, as well as another book they wrote, Sometimes I Feel. There's only a few I Am Planet books, one for the moon, one for Mars, one for the sun, the aforementioned one for the Earth, and one for the entire solar system in general. The premise is still the same, having a basic rundown of the object they're focusing on being told from the perspective of said object, which all had that Emoticai style. Again, they're pretty standard children's books. Sometimes I Feel is a little bit different. The premise of this book is showing the different emotions that one tends to feel, having the overall message being that we all experience these emotions at one point, and it's okay to express them. The style in this book is a lot more in line with the default Emoticai style. So, why am I talking about this? Why am I talking about a series of children's books that has a style that's seen in countless memes? Well, I'm not sure how many people know this, but the Emoticai existed way longer than I thought it would, along with having a more widespread use. While the original asset website doesn't have a date listed, there had been videos using that said asset that's existed since 2007. Considering that the asset is free to use, I'm assuming that the illustrator used these assets and flipped it around to have it look like a personified version of the planets. This just goes to show that it's interesting seeing a widespread use of a meme, especially if it has other purposes to serve. I do love analyzing children's books and connecting them to memes for some reason.